Welcome back to the bolted connections. In the last class, we have discussed about the eccentric loading bolted connection, that case 1, that is eccentric plane in the facing surface. Now, in the second case, eccentric normal to the plane of the facing surface. Okay. Here, in this correction, the brackets are placed which are attached to the flange. You can see here. Correct. So, here bolt groups are subjected to the loading eccentric to the shear plane, that is the line of group of bolts and the line of rotation does not pass through the center of gravity of the bolt group. Thus, the bolts are subjected to the direct shear, okay, along with the tension due to the moment. Extra angles often provide to the, you can see here, the extra angles are often provided to the bracket at the point where reactions are transformed. Okay, so we know the formula. Bolts are subjected to the combined shear and tension, page number 76, class 10.3.6 of IS 800 2007, where VSB divided by VDSB whole square plus TB divided by TDB whole square should be less than or equal to 1, where VSB will be is equal to P by N, VDB is equal to FU by root 3 into gamma MB into NNANB plus NSANB, where TB will be is equal to MYN divided by gamma VI square plus TB is equal to TB, TDB is equal to 0.9 times of FUB AN divided by gamma ML. Same old formulas. Then you should compare the results. Okay. I will be teaching the problems for this now. Okay. So, generally, before starting the problem, look here. So, eccentric loading. Load. Crossing. Bending moment. Okay. If this is a case. Section so this was a flange, that's also flange, center is the web. Now for this, bracket has been placed. Okay. So this will be your connections. There are six connections, we'll assume. Okay. So loading will be here. So eccentricity, E will be the distance measured from face to the where the load has been there. Okay. You take a section, you could, if you draw the due to the line of rotations, so having the shear stress 1, 2, 3, 4. Will be the height okay. We can measure this so this is the bolt 1, 2. So we can take measure distances y1, then this has y2, this has y3, this one has y4, this one has y5. Since the bolt groups are subjected to the loading eccentric to the shear plane, the line of action does not lie in the plane of the group of bolts. Okay. So if you now start doing the problem, you'll be able to understand this. A simple problem I'll be taking now. So design the bracket connection shown in the figure. Assume the given load as factored load, and this height will be h plus 7. So factored load, use Fe440 grade steel, 16 mm dia bolts of grade 5.6. So this is the connection they have given now. So this thing you have to design a bracket connection for this. Okay, it is very simple. We'll start the problem. So first, what you should do is calculate the bending moment for the given section. So load is 175 kilonewtons. The E is 150. So bending moment. Simple, load into perpendicular distance. M is equal to 175 kilonewtons into eccentric distance is 150 divided by 1000. It comes to 26.25 kilonewton meter. Okay, T section has been connected. Connected to the plates. So bolts are subjected to single shear. Correct. Look the figure here. It is a T section, that's all. T it is there, but the flange plate has been attached. So it is acting a single shear there. Correct. So single shear. So shear capacity of the bolt. VDSB is equal to FUB there by root 3 gamma MB into NN ANB plus NS ASB. So single shear. So FUB will be 500 here, 440. So it is root 3 into 1.25 into 1000. 0.78 times of 5 by 4 into 16 square. D is 16. Okay. So VDSB will be is equal to 36.2 kilonewtons. Okay. So FYB we require. So for FYB will be is equal to 500 into 0.6. So it is 300 newton per mm square. So calculate now tension capacity. You can skip bearing because it will be shear only will be predominant here. Okay. So VDSB will be almost your bolt value only. Okay. So tension capacity calculate. Capacity of the bolt. You know the formula. 0.9 times of FUB AN should be less or equal to FIB ASB into gamma MB divided by gamma M naught. So 0.9 times of 500 into point A n s point 78 times I pi by 4 into 16 square whole thing divided by 1000 per conversion factor should be less than fi by 300 into pi by 4 into 60 squares. Look at this always. A n net area, A sp shank area, net area will be always 0.78 times of the total area. So total area is A sp pi by 4 into d square. So 16 is the dia, 16 is the gamma mb is 1.2 by gamma m naught is 1.1. So it is 70.572 kilonewtons, which is lesser than, sorry, which is not lesser than 68.543 kilonewtons. Okay, take this value only. So TdB is equal to 68.543 divided by 1.25, so it is 54.83. So the tension capacity of bolt is 54.83. So if you calculate the n value, so n will be is equal to square root of 6m divided by n dash p vd sp. This is the formula. N is nothing but number of bolts for the connection. So m is the bending moment, n dash, okay, it is the number of planes, p it is the pitch, vdsp what we have calculated the bolt value. So here pitch you have to calculate. So pitch is equal to 2.5 times of the d, it is 40 mm. So better for connections you increase by 15 to 20 mm minimum, okay. So pitch you can take it as 65, will take 65 mm, okay. 15 to minimum, it should be minimum, it should increase by 15 to 20, go for a year. So it will be 25 have taken. So square root of 6 into 26.25 in 10 power 6, n dash will be 2 year. So pitch is 65.65. So your VDSP is 36.2 10 power of 3, so 5.77, so it is 6 volts. So 6 volts are to be provided. So what we will do here is 2 volts in the of 2 line, 2 bolt lines of 6 of 16 mm in 1 bolt line. Okay, so therefore provide 2 bolt lines of 6 number of 16 mm dia in 1 bolt line. Okay, next you calculate the depth of the bracket plate. So depth of the bracket plate . So first calculate the edge distance, required distance, 1.7 times of the 1.7 times of the d naught, or 1.5 times of the d naught, whichever is the take, when take, no problem. So 1.7 into 18, it is 30.6 mm maximum should take always. So round it up to 35 mm. Okay, how to calculate depth of the bracket plate? It is easy. Depth of the bracket plate is equal to 2 times the distance plus n minus 1 into p, where n is the number of bolts here. Okay, so 2 into 35 plus number of bolts is 6 minus 1 into a distance. So if you calculate this, 395 mm. Now calculate the height. So h b is equal to e plus n minus 1 into p. So 35 plus 6 minus 1 into pitch is 65, so it is 60 mm. So we have to calculate the line of rotation. Where will be line of rotation? Generally I told h by 7, this is the line of rotation. Okay, So line of rotation. Or nothing but it is a neutral axis. Neutral axis is located at h by 7 from the bottom of plate. So h by 7 is how much? 360 divided by 7, 551.42 mm. So we are calculating the neutral axis where it will be located on nothing but the line of rotation. Now calculate the distance of y1, y2, y3, y4, y5. So six, there are 6 bolts. So what you can do here is draw like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, from the bottom somewhere at the 51.42 here, correct? From here, now calculate the y bar or y1, y2, whatever you can call, no problem. So this will be your y1 and this will be your y2. This is your y3 and this is your y4. And this will be your y5. Okay, this will be your line of nothing but your not line of neutral axis. Okay, now calculate the y1, y2, y3, y4, y5 with respect to the line of rotation on neutral axis. Okay, so now we know edge distance and pitch, correct? So if you look at the row here, it is a line of bolt or bolt line. Okay, so from here to here it is the pitch. The in between the distance from piston distance is pitch. Okay, so y1 will be is equal to e plus pitch minus h by 7. Next, y2 will be is equal to e plus, see, look here, from here it is edge distance plus pitch minus of this distance is y1. Similarly, y2 will be what? y2 will be is equal to e head distance plus 2 times of pitch minus of h by 7. Similarly, y3 will be is equal to head distance plus 1, 2, 3 pitch minus h by 7. y4, head distance plus 1, 2, 3, 4 times of pitch minus h by 7. y5, e plus 5 times of p minus h by 7. So how many number of volts are there in the let it be n number of volts. So formula will be yn will be equal to e plus n times of pitch minus h by 7. Similarly, so here also we can do it. I'll show you 2p minus h by 7. h3 e plus 3 times of pitch minus h by 7. h4 e plus 4 times of pitch minus h by 7. 5 y5 e plus 5p minus h by 7. So for yn is equal to e plus 5 n number of bolts types of p minus h by 7, where n will be number of bolt. Okay, so when you calculate this values, so there are 2 bolt lines, correct? Now we have 2 bolt lines. So summation of yi square should be is equal to 2 times. So, 2 bolt lines are there into, so 2 times. So, 35 is the distance plus 65 minus 51.42 whole square. Nothing but E plus P minus H, H by 7. That is nothing but Y1 plus Y2, 35 plus 2 times of 65 minus 51.42 square plus 35 plus 3 times of 65 minus 51.42 whole square plus 35 plus 4 times of 65 minus 51.42 whole square plus lastly 35 plus 5 times of 65 minus 51.42 whole square. So if you add, you will do calculate all these things, your answer will be 403.47 10 raised to 3 millimeter square. So this is summation of y I square. So tensile strength of the bolt in the bolt TB is equal to M into YN divided by summation of Y I square. This is the formula, so we calculate the summation of Y I square. So it is M is 26.2 10 raised to 3. Your YN is 308.6 whole divided by 403.49 10 power of 3. So TB is equal to 20.03 kilonewton. So finally calculate VSB. VSB is P divided by N, 175 divided by 2 bolt lines. So into 2 into 6, it is 12 volts. So it is 14.58 kilonewtons. So put up in the formula, 14.58 divided by 36.2 whole square plus 20.03 divided by 154.83 whole square is lesser than or greater than 1. So the value will be 4.95 is lesser than or equal to 1. So it is, hence it is, connection is safe. Hence the connection is safe. Very simple. So 5 number of bolts are affected. So 1 bolt is the bottom. So YN will be 308.6, but nothing but 360 minus of 51.48. That's all. That is what. So that is only we got is 308. Got it. This is how we can do the bracket connection. Whenever it is in the moment acting in the plane of the bolt or eccentric loading crossing the bending moment. Okay. This is how think it will be calculated for the bracket connections. In last class, we discussed about the bracket one case one and this is case two. Now, winding up this bolt connections. Lastly, we have learned so much of the bolter connections. We have to discuss about the advantage, disadvantage, correct? See, from first to last, we have discussed the bolter connection, what is bold, what are the different types of bolts available in the market, which is the best, what are the strength, we know how to calculate the shear capacity of the bolt, bearing capacity of the blade, then again we can calculate the bolt value, number of bolts, how to calculate the efficiency of the bolts, then the bracket connection case 1 and case 2, it is the plane, it is in the perpendicular to the plane, what happens. So much things we have learnt in this session, sir. So finally, by concluding this bold session, we should know what is the advantage. Whenever we do anything, we should know what is the merit or advantage of the sections or bolted joints. So generally, they prefer the bolted connections always for the heavier loads, so that mainly it is advantageous. It is a simple operation. See, bolt joints is a simple joints, correct? In bolt joint, only two equipments is required. One is bolt and other is nut. So that joint is simple design and operation is easy. That is the only first main advantage of the bolted joint. Second thing is it is faster joint. See, when you compare to welding or riveting, welding require or riveting requires more number of time compared to the bolt joints. And if the bolted joint is very fast, easily if you know how to, you know what is the size of the bolt along with the nut, get it from the shop, just join the section. Correct. Second thing, it is not permanent joint. Whenever welding is done, you should ask the welder to come there, cut down the section or trim out the section. But no, bolts are not like that. Bolt joints are not permanent joint. It is easy to dismantle or disengage. Okay, no risk. What is this no risk? In bolted joint, no heat has been used to means bolt joint is only cold process. We do not require any kind of electricity or any kind of heat is required to joining the members. Only one thing is, we should make the groove or make the bolt hole, fit the bolt along with the bolt in the bolt hole, tighten the nut. Correct. Then next thing is less manpower is required. Whenever it is already simple operations, so bolt joint is requires low number of manpower, which is required than that of the rivet or bolt welder connections. Okay, next, no skilled labor is required. See, whenever you want to do any kind of bolted connections, you don't require. Once your design is ready, bolt is ready, only people is, you require some people to tighten the bolt or put up the bolts. Okay, next thing, no noise. Tightening and then of the bolt and nut is a silent process. Correct, it's a silent operation compared to the rivet. Rivet, it will be hammering, which will be having the much more sound. Correct, whereas here, nothing is required. Only bolt punching will be there. Put up the bolt, tighten it. Correct. So it is a tightening of bolt and nut is very silent operation compared to the rivet joints. In the rivet joints, usually what happens, hammering and punching of the rivet, bolt joints are required, a hammer, and so noise is proceed. Okay. So you can avoid this noise. Whereas in the rivet, it will be more noise will be produced. Next one thing is low cost. How can it be low cost? Generally in bolted joints, low component is used. And this component price also low. Okay, for the bolted joints, it is low. Next, highest bolt strength. What is this high bolt strength? The high bolt having the high strength than the rivet, so using the operation than time, low number of bolts required than the rivet joints. You're comparing the bolts and the rivets here. Okay, see, generally, if you use HSFC bolts, you know the advantage of the main advantage of HSFC bolts. After the failure of the slip joint, also HSFC bolts will work as an normal ordinary bolt, it will not fail easily. Got it? And if you would HSFC bolts, you can cut down the number of bolts than the common number of the joints. Okay, for the HSFC bolts, if you use, you can cut down the number of bolts already. And if you go for the ordinary bolt connections, are simple and it can be used by the persons, and less number of power is required. Okay, this is the main advantage of the bolted joints. When it comes to the disadvantage of the bolted joints, also what are the disadvantages of the bolted joints? First thing, cost of the material is high. See, what I told in the previous year to slide, it is a low cost. In a bolted joint, componently used component price is low. Whereas the whole joint, if you compare, it is a cost of material. We know iron nowadays, it is too high. So for 1 ton, almost 60,000 rupees now, 2 days later. Automatically, if you design any kind of bolt, it will be having the cost is high. Second thing, tensile strength of bolt is reduced. Where, whenever you go to the area reduction of at the root of the thread automatically, so we know calculating correct, ASB is equal to pi by 4 into D square. Whereas, AN, what happened? Net area will be lost because we know 0.78 times will be there. So 22% is washed off by doing the threading part. So what happened? Area reduction of the at the root of the thread is reduction. Then also for due to the stress concentration, due to the more tightening, tensile strength of the bolt will be reduced. Then loose fit. What is this loose fit? Sometimes it will be having loose fit, except if the turn bolts, automatically every the bolt will become loose. Correct, we know that. If it go on tightening the nut, automatically the thread will get loose, your bolt will get thrown, thread may wind up, so it will be having loose fit, automatically strength is reduced. And final thing is, whenever it is subjected to the vibration shocks, bolts may loose, bolts may get loose and then tightening. Okay, for sudden abrasion, impact, shocks and all, it may, the sharp bolts may be loose. So these are the advantage and disadvantage. They will be asking the question, mention advantage and disadvantage of the bolted connection. If you write this much and explain the points, it is enough for 10 marks. Okay, till here we have learned about the classification of the connection. I'm just revising. So classification of the connection, concentric connection, eccentric connections, and transfer of the connection, shear connection, tension connection, combined tension shear connections, then fasteners, rivets, pins, welds, simple rivet joints. These are the connections. Then what is the bolt? We have discussed about the bolt, classification of bolts, unfinished, turned, rib bolt, HFC bolt, and high strength bolts, unfinished bolts, normal ordinary bolts. We'll be not using turned or rib bolt bolts here. We'll go for the high strength bolts. So this is very important, high strength bolt. Advantage of high strength bolt will be given in the examination. Just concentrate on this always. And they may ask you the principal force mechanism of the bearing connection and the friction connection. That I have explained you about the friction connection and the bearing connection. Just go to the session number one slide. First one, first presentation, you will be getting how to do the principle of the, what is the principle involved in the friction grip bolts and the bearing connections. Okay. Then comes to the 10 bolts under the tension and playing effects I have discussed you. Then these are the classification. Generally, this is a very important lap and butt joint. Generally, you keep in mind, slab joint, majorly it is single shear. Very rarely it will be double shear. Okay. But butt joint, always it will be double shear only. Okay. Then we have discussed about the bolt holes, how to calculate the pitch, staggered length, gauge. Where, how to calculate pitch? It is very simple. 2.5 times of the die of the nominal die of the bolt given, whereas the edge distance is 1.7 times of die of the bolt hole. Whichever is higher, better 1.5 to die of the bolt hole or 1.7 to die of the bolt hole. Better always take 1.7 times of the die of the bolt hole and round off it to next higher RK. Always keep in your mind, let it be in terms of 5. It will be easy for the calculation purpose. Okay, then we calculated, then we dealt about the types of failure, shear failure, bearing failure of the bolt and plate. So which will be recommended over IS 800-2007 recommendations, how to calculate shear capacity of the bolt, bearing capacity of the bolt, where VDSP is equal to FU divided by root 3 into NN ANB plus NS ASB divided by gamma MB. Got it? So FU here will be FUB, shear capacity of the bolt, NN ANB, NN number of the shear planes in the thread, ANB net area of the bolt, NS number of shear planes in the shank. So ASB will be area of the total shank. Got it? So whatever will be, whenever it is a lap joint, it is single shear failure. So what happened? This will be gone. So directly you can take it as 0.78 times of the 554 into D square. Whenever it is two shear failure at butt joint, it is directly take it as 1.78 times of the 5/4 into D square. It is easy. Only one thing is, you should practice the problem, which I have done in the 2 or 3 sessions. Then bearing capacity, VSP is equal to 2.5 times, VDSP is equal to 2.5 times of VD, KB, T into FU divided by gamma MB, where KB is the constant to calculate by E divided by 3D naught, or P divided by 3D naught minus 0.25, or it is FU, the ratio of FU by FP, or it is 1. Okay. So thickness should be taken as minimum thickness to be taken. Then tension capacity of the bolt, 0.9 times of FUB EAN divided by gamma MB. It should be lesser than FYB ASP into gamma ML divided by gamma M0. It should be divided by again gamma MB. See, whenever it is given, take whichever is the least value. If this is the higher than this, take this value. If this is lower, then you take this. Whichever is the least, take the value of it for the tension of capacity of the bolts. When it's combined to the shear and tension, this is the formula. Now, last class we discussed it. VSP divided by VDSP plus T divided by TDNB. So, finally, HFC bolt, VSP. Every formulas you need not to buy head. Everything is in IS 800, page number 75 and 76, 77. Everything has been given here. VSP is equal to mu of into NE, KH into F0 divided by gamma MF. So, generally this coefficient of friction slip factor will be not given there, only in table number 20 has been given there. Just go on this, take the values when it's not given as 0.5552 or 5.55. generally it is sand blasted, light rusted, you can take as 0.52. okay, then what are the principle involved? We have discussed about this. Then diameter of the bolt, which is very important. Whenever it is, look at this 12-14 till 12-14 and all 13-15, only 1 mm. From 16 to 24 it is 2-2 mm. After 24 it is 33 and 3 mm, 3 mm to be added. Many people have the doubt, sir, 24 if it is given, what to do? So 24 it is given, you take 2 mm only. If I take 3 also, no problem, but take 24 it is 2 mm. After 24 mm, then increase the value for 27. Okay, so diameter of the bolt hole is nothing but diameter of the bolt plus clearance, which will be given as per the IS code of provisions. Okay, then area of the shank, area of the total shank is 5/4 d². Bolt thread is 0.7 times of 5/4 d². Then grade property, I taught you how to calculate grade property. It will be in given number, table number 1 of page 13 and 14. Kindly look at there. If they are not given, calculate this. Generally for fossil 5.8, it is not given. 4.6, 240. 4.8, 320. 5.6, 300. 5.8, 400. Okay. Next about the eccentric loading connection, which is in the plane of the facing or normal to the, nothing but one is plane, one is perpendicular. We are called, whenever it is in the plane, shear along with additional shear will be PE. This is very important. If it is perpendicular, shear along with the tension and compression. That's all. Same thing. Finally, we discuss with the advantages of bolted joints and welded joints. Along with that, we have completed the different types of formulas using formulas, and I have taught you about the different problems. Okay, try to solve much more problems. Always automatically, when still you solve the problems, you'll be not getting the good marks. You should solve the problems. Okay, very important thing here is you find out how to calculate the chain bolt. When it is chain bolting is done, I taught you the problem how to calculate the bolt value. It is normal bolting. First find out how many number of bolts are there, and then you decide. And packing plate is very important. Whenever you don't, they don't give any pie, there is a difference of the plate using. So what you should go for the packing plate. Packing plate when you use, you should make a correction in the shear. Correct. Shear capacity of, calculate the shear capacity of the bolt, VDSB, and make a correction factor. Calculate the correction factor which is given in the page number 75. Beta PK is equal to 1 minus 0.0125 times of the thickness of the plate. You can take, think class 10.3.3.3. You can directly get from the packing factor correction and calculate the value. Whenever the chain bolting is given, calculate how to calculate the weight. Each thing depends upon the whether it is in a line or a single bolt. You should calculate for the pitch or a width. If they are not given the pitch, directly total length is given, take B as the whole width. If the width is not given, they require for only pitch length, calculate for the pitch. Okay, so till now it is the bolted connections. Next, moving to the welded connections. This is very important. Okay, all people generally, they will go for the welded connection because it is easy. Correct. Might be your bolted connection may be easy, but for the compared to for the generally, they'll think it is an welding is easy. So what are these welding connections? Welding is a material joining process in which two or more parts of, look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4 sections along with the bottom column. Okay, you have placed a plate here, they have welded here also, they have welded. You can see the welding connections here. Then 4 members along with one more member, 5 members, they have been connected. So it is a material joining process in which two or more parts are joined at their contacting surfaces by suitable application of the heat or a pressure. Generally it is a heat along with the pressure. See, many welding processes are accompanied by the heat alone with no pressure applied, others by combination of heat and pressure, and sometimes still other pressures alone and no external heat is supplied. Okay, generally you will be seeing the local welding part, how they will do the welding. Correct, they will be keeping some shield along with them so that they should cover from the high heat to the high, then they'll start welding. Okay, and the first year also you'll be doing the welding sections will be there, correct? In your mechanical laboratory. So in some welding process, filler material will be added. You can see there's nothing but a filler material which will be added to the facilitating the joining, that is with the flux. Okay, the assemblage of the parts that are joined by welding are called as weldment. They are known as weldment. Welding is the most commonly associated with the melt metal parts, but the process also the joining plastics also. Okay, welding, both they will go for welding, plastic, but in our case, welding is meaning of the metal parts only. Okay, generally if you go for commercial and all commercial technical important thing and device from this following, one is welding provides a permanent joint, that is a very important thing, correct? Then welded parts become the single end time. Whole component will be, if you weld one part, look at this, if this were then 1, 2, 3, 5 sections were there, it has become one part now. The beam, column, it is used like the combination has become single part now. So then welded joint can be stronger than the parent material. If the filler material is used, then this has strength properties superior to those of the parents, and properly welding techniques are used. That is very important. Simply if you throw the welding, you don't have to proper welding, if you give a gap, it will be in trouble. Otherwise, if you do proper welding, if prop with a technique, automatically be having a more positive strength properties. Then welding is usually most economical way to the joint components in terms of material usage and fabrication cost. Alternate mechanic methods of the assembling, they require more complex shapes alternation. For example, see, if you want to drill a hole, it takes a lot of time. You require the machines, you should mark the things. If the diameter of the hole increases, then again do the patchwork. But whereas the welding is does not like this. Directly take two metals, join it properly using the flux. Okay, and riveting also will damage the plat. Welding bolt also may, bolting, drilling a hole may differ. Slightly 1 mm, it may vary. But welding, not like that. It will be having this. The resulting mechanism assemble is usually heavier than the corresponding weld metal. Okay, welding is not strictly to the factory environment. It can be accomplished in the field also. That is a very important beauty. See, whereas the bolting are locked like this, bolts should be done there only, bolt everything, only connection will be done inside. Whereas welding, you can put up in site also, or in the, put up in the shop also. Only one thing is, you will take the factor of safety will be slightly different, which will be taught in the next class. Okay, then although, so this is the advantage, what we thought. Okay, we'll be strictly to the factory environment, it can be accommodated in the fields. Although so much of advantages and there are some limitations and disadvantages, correct? So most welding operations are performed manually and are expensive in terms of labor cost. That is a very important thing. And many welding operations are considered skilled trends, and the labor to perform these operations may be scary, because heat will be there, current will be there, supposed to use the current, electricity, so they may scary of this operation. Then most welding processes are dangerous because they involve the use of high energy. Then since welding accomplishes a permanent bond between the components, it does not allow a convenient disassemble. See, whenever you want to dismantle, it is not so easy. You have to get once again the welder, then dismantle it. Finally, the welded joint can suffer from the certain quality defects that are difficult to detect. That is the problem. The defects can reduce the strength of the joint. If the welder does not weld properly, if there are gaps are there automatically, the connections are not taking the full strength, they may the strength of the joint become weak. So these are the limitations are nothing but the disadvantage. You can say one as disadvantage. If you do properly welding, it is a much advantage. Okay, look at this. This is a known as will be commonly weld process known as shielded metal arc welding. SMA small is shielded metal arc welding. Okay, so this is a commonly welding process. See, the shield metal arc welding process are called stick welding. See, look at this. This is one layer. This is one more layer. Using the electrode, the slag layer will flow on the joint, and it will be more. It will be due to the heat. It will be solid. It will be converted into the molten iron. The solidified base material will be poured here. in the direction. Look at this. How are moving the cursor? They'll start from the end and they'll move to the end like this and fill it up in a shape of arc. Can you see the arc here? It is in shape of arc. Got it? So in generally, this is known as stick welding. It's a manual process and it is the most commonly type which will be seeing wherever you see in the welding in and around of your houses. This will be doing like this. This is a process. Coated electrode is used to heat both base metal and the tip of the electrode. Okay, where the part of electrode is the deposit only on the base metal like this. As the coating on the electrode dissolves, so it forms a gaseous shield to help to protect the weld from the atmospheric impurities. Immediately it will be cooled up. Okay, then should deal about the welded joint. There are different types of welded joints available there. Okay, welding process produces a solid connection between the two pieces. We all know that, called as weld joint. A weld joint is a junction of the edges or surface of the parts that have been joined by welding. The weld joints are generally classified two types. One is types of joints and types of weld used for the joining the pieces. So we'll talk about the types of joints. There are generally five types of joints which you can look at this in the slide. First one is butt joint. Basically they'll design five joints. One is butt joint. We know about the butt, placing one next to the other. In what we will do in the world trade, we'll plate one clear, we'll place one cover plate here, bottom also we'll place one cover plate, we'll make a hole, then we will put up the bolt. Here in this butt joint, in this joint the parts lie in the same plane and they are joined at the edges. At the edges they will be joined. Generally what they will do is they will make a groove and they will join. Otherwise directly they can join. Got it. Second one is corner joint. The parts in the corner, look at this, the points in the corner joint from the right form a right angle. Can you see the right angle here? And are joined at the corner of the angle. Next one is lap joint. One placing on one above the other, lap joint. This consists of two overlapping parts. So I told you they will do arc welding here. Last figure. Okay, then next T joint. In T joint, one part is perpendicular to the other part. Approximately it looks like a T. So what they will do, they weld here also. And they will weld on the both sides. They will be doing the welding. Then edge joint. See, the part of the each edge joint are parallel at least on the one of its edges in common, and joint is made at the common edges. They will weld here. Okay, butt joint, corner joint, lap joint, T joint, edge joint. So these are the five types of joints. Next, coming to the next very important thing is types of welding. In this types of welding, there are two types. One is fillet weld and its groove weld. That time I mentioned groove. They make the groove. So what is this? Generally, the most commonly used is fillet weld only. Okay, in this fillet welds, look at this. They are the generally triangle. Can you see this? They are the triangular in shape and the joined together members. They are usually at the right angles. Look here. One is it looks like a triangle. They are at the right angles to the each other. Got it. Two things. One is it looks like a triangle. Second thing is it joined at the right angles. Got it. So they are usually most economical since they require very little surface preparation and can be used in the virtually any connection configuration. Easily they can connect this. Look at this L shape inside the single fillet corner. Directly they can do it. Whereas outside single fillet corner, they can fill it up. Then again, double fillet lap joint. Here also they can join. Here also they can join. If you go for T joint, here also they will join. Here also they will join. It is very easily we can fill up the joints and we can get the strength of the end. So only fillet weld are majorly used in the sites. Okay, next come to the groove welds. See, these are the name itself tells you groove. They are the used to fill the groove. What they will do is, for example, if they want to join here, let me assume this, two things. They will make a groove here shape and they will fill up the with the electrode. So generally used groove welds are used to fill up the groove between the ends of the two member. Groove welds can be made in the joints that have been classified as the square full penetration, V, bevel, U shape, J, flare V, flare bevel. Okay, look at this V joint. They will be grooving here and they'll fill up with the arc welding. Bevel, it also like a V shape, only broad thing. They fill up it with a flux. This is U shape and this is J shape. Look at the shape itself, depending on shape. Flare V, then flare bevel. The joints which are in the gray color, they are all the welds. Okay, another type of weldings are there. One is plug weld and solid weld. This is very important, and they are usually for the attaching the flat plates, which are shown like this. This is plug and this is slot. Okay, what we will do is using one or two more holes in the top of the top plate, and they will fill up the filler material or filler metal to fuse the two parts of the parts together. Plug weld are placed in the around the holes, whereas slots welds are placed in the elongated holes. Got it? In case of the weld, metal is placed in the hole up to the certain depth, and partial penetration or full penetration, the penetration of the depth of this plug or slot weld is difficult to inspect visually. So such welds are not often prefers. Got it? Plug welds are sort of very important, but they are not preferred in the sites. Okay, next thing, plug and welds and slot welds, where they are used then? For whenever we want to transmit the shear in the lap joint. Second thing is connecting a component of the built up member, such as web doubler plates, which will prevent for the buckling. Okay, then third thing is conceal the connection for the steel that are exposed to the architectural season. Then fourth thing is to add strength to the connections with fillet welds. The next thing is neither plug nor slot welds should be used where tension force is normal to the plane that is facing the surface. Then should not be used to support the cyclic loads. Okay, then they will go for the plug welds. Next, coming to the different types of welding specification. Generally, these types of welding specification, there are four things which are showing the figures. This is known as gas welding, and this is electric welding. I think everyone has seen this. Gas welding will be used for the joining the two plates. Thin plate sections, they will go for the gas welding, whereas the electric welding, then flux arc welding, then plasma welding and cutting. Okay, there are different types of four types of welding specification: gas welding, electrical welding, flux arc welding, plasma welding and cutting. Okay, then next, coming to the, we know, see, look at this, we know flux is nothing but welding is a process of returning two material parts by the melting of the material in the inner surface, so that they will be having the bond together. A filler material, generally whenever they go for tipping, it should be used for to join the two parts. See, the parts being joined are referred as the base material and the filler is referred as the weld metal. Okay, since structural welding is typically done by electrical arc process like this, okay, like the arc process, the weld metal is typically supplied via weld electrodes, sometimes known as welding rods. I think you know people about knowing welding rods. Look at this. This is a welding rod. They will be supported like this. They will be having here. Through that, the heat will be passed. This electrode will flow here. It will melt. Then it will be forming an arc welding. Okay. This is the generally the welding. If you go to the market, the tensile strength of the weld electrodes can be of 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110 or 120 KSI. Okay, corresponding electrodes have been specified with the nomenclature, some E60XX, E70XX, A80XX. If you go to market and just go to hardware shop, we'll be getting about this. Okay, these are the things of the welding specification. In the next class, I'll teach you about the design, how to design a fillet welding, and we'll start the problem. Thank you.